Jody's kitchen. So I'm gonna be doing a small harvesting, just a small one.
Tamil.
Nana ஒரு குட்டி குட்டிய நான ஒரு குட்டிய ஒரு ஹார்வெஸ்டிங் பண்ண
போறேன். சரி ஓகே. ஸோ ஃபஸ்ட்டு ரேடிஷ் சாரி ஆனியன் பிக் பண்ணியாச்சு. இப்போ முள்ளங்கி பிக் பண்ணலாமா?
முள்ளங்கி என்ன?
ரேடிஷ்.
ஓ ரேடிஷ்.
எஸ்.
முள்ளங்கி.
கம் ஆன் இங்கே இருக்கு. So she is going to try to harvest this radish. It's really hard. So I was telling her I will do it, but she wanted to try. Let her try. If not, I will pick this radish. I will post how to grow radish in Melbourne from seed until harvesting stage in my future videos. I took all the clippings, how it grown, what are all the problems, what are all the mistakes that I did while growing radish. So I will include all that in my radish video. So if you want to grow onion, you can watch my onion video that I have posted previously. So it was really hard for her. So I'm going to pick the radish. I'm going to make sambar with radish. So one is enough for me. So I'm going to harvest just one. I already harvested 4 to 5 radishes before.
Go, Amma! Go, Amma! Wow! Amma, apdi iru. We done the radish and onions. Now we're gonna pick some carrots.
So ipo mullangi parichaachu. Carrot vandu evlo big ah valandirukku paakalama? We are going to try how big is the carrot is grown. The leaves are on the side la idu pannittu pannu. Well, but when we harvested the carrot, it was really small, so we have to leave some more days. I will post in my future videos.
Don't pick the small one.
The carrots are grown. I'll show that in my future video.
It's a small one, like so. It has to grow bigger.
Yeah.
It's a tiny carrot.
You think it's big because of the leaves,
but yeah.
When you take it out, it's like.
Okay, let's wait for don't take it out.
Oh, okay.
You can't regrow that.
Oh, okay.
So idu romba kuttiya irukke. Actually it's broken, see? It's broken.
Oh.
It's still in the ground.
Yeah, I can feel it. What's that?
We are going to get a new corn.
Corn.
So this video is actually taken few weeks back. Now in my garden the corn is grown actually. I will show you all when I harvest corn, so you will get an update as well. We can grow corn in Melbourne. It will grow really fast and it's easy to grow as well. These pumpkin plants are I have not put the seeds at all. But it's grown so beautifully, and these amaranth leaves, I just left it for seeds for next year. I will show you all how to collect the seeds in my future videos as well.
So there's 2 onions, but one is very.
The onion is orange.
So there's 2 oranges, but one is very small and it's still very green. This is changing its color and it's bigger. So we're gonna pick one And then we
summer lesson.
And then we can look at the flowers.
Mm.
So if it is sampling the ticket.
Okay, super.
Inga ஒரு பூ இருக்கு.
Mm.
அப்புறம்
இங்க ஒரு பட் இருக்கு.
பட் ஓ ஆமா இங்க கொஞ்சம்
So I'm going to pick some curry leaves. When you pick curry leaves, you have to break the branches. Then only you will get more new branches. I'll show you some of the tips and care that I follow to grow my curry leaf plant. In Melbourne, we can grow curry leaf plant, but we need to care little bit to. If it's grown bigger, then you will not have any problem. But to get that stage, you need to care so much. I'm going to pick some mint as well. I have already posted how to preserve mint. I will give that link in the description box below. If you didn't watch that video, please go and have a look and you will get good tips to preserve your mint. If you're growing more in your garden, you can always follow that. I'm following that and I never bought mint from shops. I always pick from my garden or from my freezer. So I'm going to pick some of the flowers for my prayer, and I used to decorate at home.
Wow.
So I pick a lot of flowers, and this is almost a finishing time. I'm going to trim all the branches and I will get more flowers next year as well. So when you trim your rose branches, you have to trim really bigger. Take out all the branches and you will get new leaves.
Wow.
And branches more for next year. And these samandi flowers, it's not a season time, but still it's growing. I'm happy, so happy to see those flowers. I use these flowers mostly to my prayers.
Wow. I'm a fig cartela.
And these are all my fig tree. I'm getting more fruits, but it's not growing really big and it's taking so much time to ripen the fruit. So if you know anything,
it's all growing.
Okay, pick some green chilies
below so everyone will get benefit out of it. And these chili plants are from seeds.
All
my dad planted all these chili plants.
All the big chilies.
Yeah. Still giving me chilies every year. I don't trim any, I don't do anything to these chili plants. I just add some of the compost that I prepare at home. That's all I do, and I water it regularly. And every year I'm getting chilies from these plants. This is more than 4 years now, the same plant. I'm getting still chilies. So I wanted to try other varieties of chilies next year. So when I do that, I will share that video with you all so you can try in your garden as well. So I'm going to pick only the amount that I use for this week, and just like 50 to 20 chilies. That's
we also
more than
have
enough
yellow
for me
chili, which is supposed to be green chili, but it's not grown yet.
Now she's going to pick some bay leaves. I'm going to make biryani today, so I'm picking some bay leaves. I have already posted how I trim my branches of these bay leaves, and also I have showed how to dry these at home and to store these leaves for 1 year. You can watch that video.
நான் வந்து இப்போ கொஞ்சம் பிரியாணி செய்யப்போ அதுக்காக தான் கொஞ்சமாக பறிக்கிறேன். மீதி வந்து நான் ட்ரை பண்ணிடுவேன். ஆக்சுவலாக கட் பண்ணிட்டு ட்ரை பண்ணிடுவேன். ஜஸ்ட் ஒரு குக்கிங்க்கு யூஸ் பண்ணுறதுக்கு மட்டும்.
இன் கேரளா தே மேக் டம்ப்ளிங்ஸ்.
ஐம் கோயிங் டு குக் பிரியாணி. தட்ஸ் ஐம் பிக்கிங் ஒன்லி ஃபியூ லீவ்ஸ். அதர்வைஸ் ஐ ஜஸ்ட் யூஸ் டு ட்ரிம் அண்ட் ட்ரை திஸ் லீவ்ஸ் அண்ட் ஸ்டோர் இட். தட்ஸ் எனஃப் லைத்யம்மா.
So, if I make that dessert, I will share that in my future videos.
Good. What's it?
My daughter, she loves to do harvesting videos. She loves to do harvesting.
Next, we're going to be taking up these four pink and red flowers.
Dahlia.
Dahlia. Last year they grown, but then they just, because it was very windy, it all just flew off and then it all broke and then it was all dry.
Okay.
So this time it's our chance to pick them all.
Adivana, pick the good ones. Yeah. Cut it.
It's like a wobble
so
head.
So beautiful flower, isn't it? Like, yes. Such a beautiful flower.
Look at it. Such a beautiful flower. So many layers and the color is awesome flower. We
it's
just love head. This flower. It gives more color to my house. So I keep this in the water. You can find these plants in Bunnings as
well.
And it's easy to grow as well. And she's going to pick some jasmine flowers as well.
The jasmine
I got
flowers
really like
smell
one,
very
every
nice.
Day I used to pick around 10 flowers, 10 to 15 flowers every day during the season time. So I'm going to try if I can multiply this plant. I'm trying some of the
and
methods.
The
if it is successful, I will definitely share those tips in my future videos.
Wow.
If you're growing any other new varieties of flowers or vegetables, please share
Get
that
it.
In the comment section below so everybody will get benefit and everyone can try that as well. So this is my sour orange. As I said in my previous videos, we consume a lot of lemon, lime and this sour orange.
You can do it. Oh, you got it.
It's
big.
It's a big one. Two fruit is more than enough to make juice. Family.
So we have some tomatoes
so
here. They're not fully grown, so we're not going to pick them. But they look very nice. It's like a white stripe in the middle of the stem.
So these tomatoes are not ripe when we were harvesting this one. So I shared the harvesting of tomatoes as well in this video. So I harvested actually 1 week later some tomatoes and some other vegetables as well. I'm getting turkey berries this year. I will share that as well
Look
in my future videos.
It's a nice blueberry.
So the blueberries are the last ones we are picking now. It's almost all the fruits are over. So we have to wait for one more year to get more fruits next year. I hope I'll get more than this year. It's easy to grow. Blueberry plant is easy to grow. You don't need much maintenance, and also just add some banana powder or eggshell powder. That's more than enough to this plant. You will get a lot of fresh blueberries in your garden itself. Grow more, stay healthy. So pomegranate tree, I got nearly more than 100 flowers, but no one was turned into fruit. If you know any reason, please leave any suggestion or ideas
so
in comment section below.
So I'm going to be showing you what and everything we've been harvesting. So radish, one radish, half a carrot, five onions, three apples, one orange, two sour orange, curry leaves, mint leaves, bay leaves, chilies, mallipu, which is jasmine flower, roses and
dahlia
and the yellow flowers.
So this video is actually exactly after 1 week. I'm going to pick some more vegetables. So my husband is going to harvest some gongura leaves, that is sorrel leaves. It's so tasty leaves that I love these leaves. We cook with these leaves with goat meat, any meat, it goes very well. Even seafood goes very well with these leaves. This leaf tastes sour, but it's so delicious. I just love this plant. So I'm going to make a gongura rice, that is sorrel leaves rice, a quick rice variety. I'm going to show that recipe as well in this video. If you want to try, you can try this. If you don't have this plant at home, don't worry, you can always buy store bought gongura pickle. It's always available in all Asian shops or Indian grocery shops. You can get that and you can try this recipe as well. It tastes so good. I have tried before. And I'm going to leave this plant for seeds. So if I get more seeds, I'm going to store it for next year. I wanted to plant more gongura plants next year. And this is my white cucumber variety, that is dosakha. We just love this vegetable. Back in India, my mom used to make more chutneys and dal varieties with this vegetable. So I'm going to make a dal variety today, so my kids will enjoy this. But this plant, it didn't turn up really well, but I got two vegetables, and also the size was really small. It's not grown so big, and he's harvesting some cucumbers. Last week I have harvested some cucumbers already. I forgot to take the video, so this is my second harvesting of cucumbers. The size of these cucumbers was only like a short one, and also there are some thorns on top on the skin side. I don't know what type it is. And this is tomatoes. It's ripe and it's ready to harvest. I'm going to harvest these tomatoes. I just love this. And when you see, even though in supermarkets the tomatoes are $1 or $2, when you harvest even one tomato from your garden, the feeling is really different and you will be really satisfied and you will be amazed as well. So you will get more encouragement when you do harvesting in your garden, and that's really important, and it will boost up you to grow more vegetables or fruits, whatever that you like to grow in your garden. So always grow more and try more new vegetables or fruits. And if you think those were any valuable comments or ideas, please share with us as well. And let's start the recipe of gongura rice, that is sorrel rice. So I have taken one bowl of gongura leaves. I washed them a couple of times and then I chopped it finely. So you can paste that as well. That will give you more flavor also. So if you want to do that, you can always do that. But I'm going to chop them and then use in my cooking. You can do both the methods. So take and add half a teaspoon of mustard seeds, half a teaspoon of fenugreek seeds, half a teaspoon of urad dal, and half a teaspoon of cumin seeds. And I'm going to add 5 dried red chilies. Dry roast this until the mustard seeds start to splutter. So on, and the lentils, the urad dal and fenugreek seeds will turn into golden color. So once the mustard seeds start to splutter, turn off the flame and then transfer this into a mixer jar or blender. Grind this into a fine powder. And then we can use this at the end when we mix the rice, because it's already roasted, so we don't have to start add at the beginning. You can do that as well, but I'm going to add this powder at the end. So just dry roast. Do not burn fenugreek seeds. You will get bitter taste if you burn it. So I'm going to grind this into a fine powder. So in the same pan, add around 3 tablespoons of oil. It depends on how much rice that you are going to mix it. So I'm going to mix 2 cups of cooked rice. So to that, 3 tablespoons of oil is enough. So once the oil is heated up, we are going to use all the seasonings. You You can use any oil. I'm using sunflower oil today. So once the oil is hot, add 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds, 1/2 teaspoon of urad dal, 1/2 teaspoon of chana dal, and then you can use cashews or you can use peanuts as well. I'm going to use peanuts, but it's a roasted peanuts, and I'm going to add that at the end. You will get that crunchy peanut flavor taste. That's why I'm going to add at the end. If you are using a raw peanut, this is the right time to add your peanuts. To this, I'm adding just 3 green chilies. That is from my garden. You can adjust it according to your spicy level. Remember, we already added dried red chilies, and also we are using after once we grounded that one. So add some turmeric powder, mix it well, and then add all the chopped sorrel leaves. So you, as I said, you can use it as a paste as well. If you use it as a paste, you will get a more light green color rice. So that will look very nice as well. But I like to have like a leaf. When I bite, I wanted to taste that sour leaves, so I'm using like this. So as I said, you can always try making into paste. If your kids don't like these leaves, if they're separating this, then just grind it and then add, just toss it for 2 minutes and then sprinkle some water and then cover it and cook for just 2 minutes, not more than that, and just sprinkle the water, do not add too much. So the leaves are cooked perfectly. Just mix it once. See, the chilies are roasted as well. Add cooked rice. I'm using 2 cups of rice here. And also this is Sona Masoori rice. So you can use basmati rice as well. It will taste even more better. But I have Sona Masoori rice at home, so I'm going to use it. Now add the ground masala that we prepared earlier, and also add the roasted peanuts or cashew nuts, whatever that the nuts that you like, you can add it and mix it thoroughly. Check the salt consistency. If you think you want more salt, you can add at this stage. I'll mix everything and then I will show you. So to this rice, I'm cooking fish fry. So it's a best combo. Even just omelet will go with this rice. To me, just this rice is more than enough because I love gongura leaves. So if you want to serve to your guest, you can serve this with chicken fry or fish fry. Any fries will go better. If you are vegetarian, potato roast or paneer roast will go along with this one. It will taste so delicious. Don't forget to try this recipe. As I said, if you don't have sorrel leaves, don't worry. You can always buy gongura pickle from Indian grocery shops and then try this recipe. And if you like it, please thumbs up and share that in the comment section below. It's ready to serve. I'm going to enjoy my lunch with gongura rice and fish fry. I like to have these chilies also. It tastes so good with this rice. So if you try some other recipes like this, please leave that in the comment section below. I'm going to enjoy my gongura rice. I'll see you in another.
If you like this video, keep on harvesting and share with your friends. Please subscribe to Nageshwari's Kitchen, and we'll see you in another video. Bye!